Hello from the Bureau of Meteorology. I'm climatologist Andrew Watkins.
And I'm hydrologist Claire McCluskey.
We've seen some great rainfall over the past month, Claire, and particularly since the start of March. Tell us a little bit more about what we've seen.
That's right. We've had a really good start to March with lots of rain across much of the country. That's been brought about by ex-tropical cyclone Esther as it moved down the sort of southeast of the country. Importantly, it's brought much needed rainfall to areas that missed out on that February rainfall, particularly in the central part of Australia here.
Yeah, it's really helped out with the drought, of course, in many areas. What's that done to the soil moisture?
Well, as you can see from this map here, there's a lot of blue, and that means we've got very much above average conditions across much of the country. There are some dry areas here through Western Australia and into South Australia, but overall our catchments are a lot wetter.
And a big difference from what we've seen over just the last couple of months.
That's right, it's really changed in the last couple of months. But what can we expect looking forward at the next few months?
Well, of course, we're all hoping to see a bit more rainfall to follow up. In terms of the climate drivers, at the moment we have a warm patch out here in the tropical Pacific Ocean near the dateline. Unfortunately, that would normally draw moisture away from Australia, but the good news is that's being counteracted by these warm ocean temperatures to the north of Australia, but also out here in the eastern Indian Ocean. And in fact, those eastern Indian Ocean temperatures typically would result in more northwest cloud bands over the coming season, which typically bring some great rainfall.
So more or less rainfall, what can we expect?
Well, certainly with the outlook, we're seeing increased odds of above average rainfall through parts of the Northern Territory, Western Australia, and also into South Australia and Victoria as well. So some good conditions likely for the start of the cropping season. But up here in Queensland, eastern Queensland, looking drier than average as a result of that pattern out there in the tropical Pacific.
Okay. And looking at stream flow, so with that rainfall outlook in mind, and given the recent rainfall we've had, we're expecting more than 60% of sites to have near median or high flow conditions. The high flow conditions sort of along the eastern coast of Australia there. Other areas that weren't so lucky with the rain, we're expecting low flow conditions, and that's scattered throughout different parts of the country there.
And certainly that drier conditions up in the top end and so on are being reflected in the lower stream flows likely up there at the moment as well.
That's right.
If we turn to the temperature outlook, across northern Australia, high odds of having above normal temperatures during the daytimes. But in those areas in the south that might get a little more rainfall, things are looking a little bit closer to average, possibly even cooler than average in parts of the southwest.
Thanks, Andrew, and thank you for joining us. Please keep updated on our website, and we'll see you next time.